searching for too long. I can't work out where you are. Where have you gone?
With me today, I have the girl whose voice is crystal diamond, anything sparkly and enchanting and glittery. Liv Dawson!
Hi!
Hello!
I don't know if I have to.
No, you do have the voice that literally, whatever someone's doing, they have to stop and listen.
Thank you.
You just make people stop.
Thank you.
Are you good today?
Yeah, I'm really good, thanks.
Thank you for joining me. I'm so excited. Now, I've got to say, I didn't catch your Amira show, unfortunately, but I was at your show before, which was, I don't know what it was called. It was a deep, dark room with candles and it was flower something.
Oh, blue flowers.
Blue flowers. Yes. Oh my gosh. I literally walked into like Narnia when I walked in there.
It's crazy in there. The venue's amazing.
Like, you were amazing. How was that show for you? Your voice is incredible.
No, that was so much fun. I really enjoyed that.
Was that like one of your first shows? Or?
Yeah, that was like one of my first ones.
Okay.
Yeah, it was really good.
Really, your voice is like, it grabs me, like, it's so soulful.
Thank you.
You're like beyond your years. Do people tell you that a lot?
Yeah, I've heard it once before.
You must have. would you agree? Like, because when did you actually start singing?
I started singing when I was about like 8 or 9, so quite a while ago.
Definitely beyond 2 years. Okay.
That's a little bit. So yeah, quite a while ago, and just like recording music since I was about 13. So I've always been like recording music and singing and everything. And then yeah, like released my first song last year. So it's been a long journey.
So when you were 13, what did you put out? Like, what was the song?
No, I didn't put any songs out when I was 13. I just recorded music, just like going in the studio and like writing myself. And I was doing a lot of gigs as well, like in pubs and stuff, like little gigs. Yeah, I was really young, like thinking about it now.
And you did Tapestry when you were 16, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Because you know, I need to start taking love advice from you, because if you can go that deep at 16, like, what? But I guess they do say, you know, the first love cuts deep, and you know, young love.
Yeah.
So yeah, I guess your emotions are intensified when you're younger.
Because
when I was 16, I literally wanted to write myself a novel because of my life was so dramatic.
So dramatic.
But yeah, tell me about that time then when you put out Tapestry.
Yeah, Tapestry was like kind of, I don't know, I wrote it with two of my friends, and it was the first time we wrote together ever. So like we wrote it on the first day, and we didn't think it was going to be like the song that I released. We just thought, oh, this is a nice song. And then I re-recorded it and heard it back, and I was like, this is the one. Like, because it explains me so much as an artist and a person, and like it relates to a lot of people. Like, a lot of people can relate to it, and I think that's why everyone seemed to like it so much, because it's quite relatable.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Well, you definitely are beyond your years if you're putting out such an intense, you know, song like that when you were 16. How do you kind of, do you have any advice to people kind of finding their feet early? How did you do that? Because not many people can do that.
It takes a lot of time. Like, I think people don't know how much I wrote before I released Tapestry. Like, I was writing for about 4 years before, and just like trying so many different things. And like, when I got to Tapestry, it was like, this is just everything that I've ever wanted in one of my songs. And like, it's just kind of gone from there. I don't think my sound will ever stay the same, but it will always like change and like grow and whatever. So
did you kind of like go down a rocky road or rap road? You're like, nah, not for me.
I mean, maybe not like rap, but like, you know,
a rap song would be absolutely amazing.
Yeah, no. But yeah, like, I've been through like a few different genres, and like, I always stayed in the soul, like R&B, like side of things, but I've always wanted to make that sound my own. And when Tapestry came along, it was perfect.
Well, it's got about 3 million streams on Spotify, yeah. So I'm sure people are digging it.
Yeah, I hope so.
But it's mad, like, how do you, obviously, because all this is new, you know, like interviews and shows and love and fans and this and that and videos. Like, how does it feel? Are you like,
it's really exciting.
Freaking out?
Yeah, like, it's so exciting, and I'm so like humbled to just like be able to do what I want to do. And it's so nice that I can release music and let people know what I've been working on, and it's really nice. I love it. It's very exciting.
You have healing music, by the way. literally like you've healed. Well, now you've healed millions of people. So you're a singer, songwriter, and healer.
Yay.
Great. But no, when, so did you go? Did you go into a drama school or singer school or?
No, not really. No.
Oh, none of that.
No.
Who was it that kind of like pointed you in that direction, or was it literally just you?
I think it was just, it was me, and it's what I wanted to do, and it was also like, so I had so much support from my family, and obviously like they're quite honest with me, so if they didn't think that I had enough to like do what I want to do, and if I should do something else, then they would have told me. Yeah. So like, I mean, hopefully they would have told me by now. Yeah. But yeah, like it's a lot of support from my family.
I know a few people that no one's told them they're actually rubbish, yet they're just carrying on. People, tell your friends if they are not good, okay? I know I wouldn't do it, but people should. I'm gonna, the vibes I'm getting of you is like an early Katy B kind of, like before, you know, the rising star, or even Tinashe, even a bit Solange, even Lana Del Rey, like that's wow. That's all you mixed together.
Thank you.
Which person would you like to go out of those four?
I don't know really, probably like Lana Del Rey.
Lana
I love Del Rey.
Lana I Del love Rey. Her, she's so buff, love
yeah,
her.
She's so
Who
good.
Is it that you are loving?
Beyonce. I love like loads of old singers like Lauryn Hill, like Amy Winehouse.
Fab.
But I love new music as well. Like I'm loving Khalid or Khalid's new album.
Mm-hmm.
I love it so much. It's like it's gonna be like my album for this year.
Oh yeah, it's vibesy.
It's so good. And yeah, like I love Georgia Smith. I love that Drake has included her on his album.
And where did that even come
crazy.
From?
Crazy. Like, and it's so nice of him.
Like the equalness between UK and America on there.
Yeah.
It's got gigs twice.
I know. It's mad.
So mad.
It's so cool though. I love Drake.
Like, oh yeah, of course. I just want to give him a hug. He's
yes.
the kind of guy that I really...
He's so cute.
He's so cute. So right, Liv, so you have four singles. It's Tapestry, Still, Reflection and Open Your Eyes.
Yeah.
What's your fave one?
Oh my God. Probably Tapestry, just because it's like my first
your
release.
Baby.
Yes, my baby. Yeah. Yeah. It's the one that I like, I always go back to, and it's just... It's my favourite, yeah.
Lovely. And I've also known that you are assisted by the mentors of Jimmy Napes, Tobias Gesso, Bruno Major, SG Lewis and Disclosure.
Yeah.
That's quite a lot for... How old are you?
18.
18! How did you get there? It's like you had it all figured out. Like, how did you kind of buck up with these people? Did they contact you? Or let's go for Disclosure then.
It was kind of just... So Disclosure I met through Jimmy Napes and they wanted to jump into a session, and the first session we done was about... 3 years ago now, and that's when we wrote Searching, my new one. That was that about 3 years ago, and then we've wrote like a few more times like since then, and they're really great guys, like, and what they've done to Open Your Eyes and Searching is amazing.
There's a long list of people that want to be working with them.
Yeah.
And you're working with them.
Yeah,
like,
it's mad. It's really
mad.
Cool.
It's such an achievement.
Yeah, it's so nice.
So can we talk about Searching, please? Now, I read that you said, I wrote Searching about an old crush I had and they kept slipping away from me. You know, when you're desperately trying to make more of a relationship which isn't there and searching to find a way to move forwards.
Yeah.
I agree. We've all been there.
Yeah,
I've been
definitely.
There. So yeah, explain the story.
It's about like a few things. It can be, that's what I like about it. It's quite versatile. Like I feel like a lot of people can relate to it. But yeah, it's about an old crush and it's kind of just about how it, like searching for something that like isn't there. And that shows it in the video as well, because we done the video and that was released about like a couple of weeks ago now. And it's like... you know, like shown really well and like everyone really likes it. But that's like the story, like on the video, and like it's about, yeah, just like someone slipping away. And
it's literally like the epitome of young love, that video.
Yeah.
I
yeah.
love it. Like,
yeah.
But it's so real. That's exactly
yeah,
what would
yeah,
happen.
It's real, yeah.
Like the girl would go over to another guy and then be
yeah.
like, oh, actually, I like you. Come back.
Yeah. 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 Exactly.
And you also got to have the 90s kind of vibe to all your videos. The videos that go through the theme of 90s. Are you
yeah.
loving 90s vibe?
I love 90s vibes.
Literally, my friend, she was having a party the other day and she wanted a themed party. She goes, oh, like, I really want to go for a 90s vibe, and I was like, so it's just a normal party then, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
We're all gonna work off,
yeah,
we're all wearing 90s
it's all
anyway.
Coming back, yeah. Definitely.
But let's talk style. If you did want to let's say you have a favorite clothes shop that you wanted to be the face of the campaign of, anyone could be listening, so pick wisely.
Yeah.
who would you like to go for?
Oh geez, probably like I mean, that's very cliche, because, but like, I literally shop there like all the time.
Probably
like Urban Outfitters or somewhere. Like, that is my life. Like, I can't go in there and then like find something I don't like. Like,
oh, yeah,
I like
for sure.
Everything in there.
Oh, I agree.
And I love it. It's my favourite.
Even in your other videos, there was another one. Is it Open Your Eyes? And
yeah.
There's another 90, like,
yeah,
I'm catching the vibes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like double denim.
And you have a video where there's two songs, and there's Billen on the remix?
Yeah, yeah, that's that is Open Your Eyes.
Open Your
yeah.
Eyes. How come there's two videos? You just fancied going down that road, or?
Oh, Open Your Eyes.
Yeah, there's one where it's like you're looking, and then there's another.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. There's like,
why not throw in two videos?
Yeah,
though?
Two videos. Why not? I mean, I didn't really think of it as like two videos. It was more just like kind of the remix video than like the obviously the Open Your Eyes like main kind of one. So yeah,
I love it. Thanks. It's quite ballady. All your songs are really like,
yeah,
you know, you're looking into my soul. But I like it. I love it.
Thank you.
And you're going to be looking into people's souls in Leeds, Bristol, and Birmingham.
Yeah,
is that right?
Looking into people's souls.
Now, obviously, I know what went down in the lovely candle-filled Narnia show that you did. Yeah. But let everyone know what happens at a Liv Dawson show.
So I had my first headline show about 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago now, at Amira, which was amazing. It was so nice to like meet everyone who came, because it was sold out, which was like crazy.
That is crazy.
It's so cool. And yeah, it's so cool. It's like everyone was just like singing my songs, and like it's really nice.
Is that the first proper time like people were actually singing your lyrics? Oh my god, that must weird. Be so weird.
It's so weird.
You must
like,
be bugging out.
Yeah. It was mad. I was like seeing all the videos after, and it was like so weird.
Oh well, I've also caught some of your videos of you bathroom singing.
Oh yeah,
I like it.
On my Instagram.
Yeah, you kind of kicked out on bathroom selfies and put in bathroom singing. I much prefer yours.
Thank you.
No, I like it. Are you going to be keeping up the bathroom
yeah,
singing session?
Yeah, I like doing little videos on Instagram and stuff. It's like I like watching it, like seeing people like put little like, I don't know, 30-second clips and stuff. So I was like, I'm going to try it out for myself. Yeah. And it was good.
Well, everyone wanted to go to a Liv Dawson show. Just check out the mini clips and you'll know what you're in for. You'll want more when you go to the show. For sure, for sure. And you're also signed to...
To Method.
To Method, that's yeah. It. How is it? How did that happen?
Yeah, it's so cool. It's kind of through like just knowing like Jimmy and Disclosure, and like it's just like a little family. Like, yeah, it's really nice.
Fab. Has things changed since being signed, or
not really? No, like I mean, I they're so supportive, so like, and they don't push anything, so it's kind of like really it's been a natural process for me. Yeah, and everyone's so lucky there. It's great.
Fabulous. Big up Method.
Yeah, big up Method.
Big up Method. Now please, Liv, let us know everything that you have coming up. Is there anything, you know, more singles, videos, what's going on?
So I'm just doing tons of shows at the moment. I mean, well, yeah, like tons. I mean, like loads of festivals. yeah, so
which festivals are you doing?
I've got Wildlife coming up.
Oh my gosh, I'm so sick.
I've got
Wildlife.
Dot to Dot Festival, Bergen Fest. I've got Latitude coming up. I've got loads. I literally
right.
can't
you,
even...
Yeah, you've got quite a few.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you a festival to, like, girl before?
Yeah.
Okay.
I love festivals.
Oh,
they're
me
my
too.
Favourite.
Yeah, putting glitter on my face at any given opportunity is
exactly.
The way to go.
It's the best.
Oh, Liv, can I just say good luck with everything?
Thank you very
festival
much.
It up.
Thank you.
You are fantastic. You look into people's souls and we like it. The healer and singer-songwriter Liv Dawson. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.